would like to talk to you. I saw the article in the LA Times on you and everything you're doing for green. How did you get involved in the environment?
I think I got involved, you know, pretty much when I grew up, like, you know, climbing trees in Paris. But also, like, really, like, 10 years ago, when I started, like, thinking about the millennium, what would be my new resolution? And I realized, actually, that I was producing a lot of shoes, you know, with my company, Ethnies, and I needed to do something. And eventually, I met Daryl Hannah, you know, the actress Daryl Hannah, and we went to a ranch in Colorado. And we took this car that was working on vegetable oil, and I couldn't believe it. You know, I was going up and down the hill, like, 80 miles an hour, and I think she was getting it from the restaurants, and I was thinking, how can you get like a car to work on vegetable oil that actually the restaurant give you? You don't have to buy petroleum. It can be a way to resolve, you know, all those crazy war on petroleum, you know. And from there on, I say, okay, I'm going full speed, you know, on the environment. And I built a headquarter in Lake Forest here, you know, in Orange County, and basically works on all solar energies, all eco building, you know, basically. And yeah, we are all sustainable, you know. So it was very exciting.
And now you're making furniture out of skateboards? Is that what I...
I tried to figure out, like, how can I influence different people to do something about the environment, because actually it's the future. You know, we're in the eco-revolution right now, and we're in the age of consciousness. So we're ready to inspire a lot of people. So I decided to do a furniture, too, as a project. And basically the idea, I'm recycling, like, leftover skateboard from manufacturer and making a beautiful, like, mid-century design furniture. But also I started doing some clothes, because when I show my movie I did with Leonardo DiCaprio at Cannes in 2007, the 11th hour, I couldn't walk the red carpet with a polluting tuxedo. So I made actually a tuxedo with music tapes. And from there on, I mean, came the idea that, you know, maybe it would be a cool idea if I make new other pieces to it. And Vanity Fair really liked, you know, the idea. Everybody.
Well, what made you think of using tapes?
Music tape, yeah, because I thought, okay, well, I find this fabric that we say, weave music tape that looks like shiny and it looks very pretty. And then from there on, from the music tape to parachute. So this is jacket here, for example, it's made of like a parachute.
Oh,
it's from parachute from
that's
the air,
nice.
From the Air Force. And it's good because it's like it's tailored, so it looks nice. But at the same time, it's very light, so it's very practical. So it's funny because for every container of finished product that we have 32 containers of wasted product. So when you think about it, you know, there's so much stuff you can do with those 32 containers. And that's why basically I'm trying to demonstrate that it's really possible to do something that looks good, you know, that functions good, you know, that people can aspire to have.
Okay. Are you tracking your carbon footprint then? Is your building carbon neutral?
Sure, definitely. We're tracking the carbon footprint. Actually, in 2007, I went around the world checking all my offices and how much CO2 we were creating. And we find out we're creating 80 million pounds of CO2 as a company. And I told my staff, okay, this is it. Now we're going carbon neutral by 2020. So we're doing everything we can basically to reduce our CO2 and get to zero in 2020.
Oh, well, you're a pioneer. What do you have planned for the future?
Well, my dream is like will be that, you know, when you fly over city, you don't even see city anymore. You know, you see forest. You know, you see building that creating energy, you know, and suddenly you are really much more connected with the environment and everybody get much more harmony with themselves and live much more happier.
Oh, okay. Well, I love your jacket. What's the name of this line of clothes?
This line called CPAS. It's C-P-A-S.
Okay, thank you so much.
Pleasure.